This video I am going to explain FIFO and LIFO method in pricing of material issue. So what is the meaning of pricing of material issue? See, in cost account, ascertainment of accurate or exact cost is one of the main objective of cost accounting. In cost accounting, we'll have different topics like materials, overheads, labor cost. These are the different topics in cost accounting. But in cost accounting, the main objective is to ascertain, to find out the exact total cost of production is the main objective. So in order to ascertain the accurate cost, which depends upon the correct valuation of material used in the production department. So generally in an organization, we'll have different departments. For example, purchase department, stores department, production department, finance department, HR department. These are the different operational areas in the organization. In the organization, in purchase department, their main function is to acquire the raw material from the different supplier. Before they purchase the product, they'll collect the information from various supplier. They'll collect the quotation. After receiving all the information, they'll decide which one is best. They'll analyze the quotation based on some criteria and finally they'll make a decision to purchase the particular material from the particular supplier. So generally, in purchase price of material fluctuate on account of different reason. The first one is change in the product price. They won't buy the entire raw material from one particular supplier on one time. They'll purchase quantity, a smaller quantity or huge quantity or some limited quantity or agreed quantity from different supplier in a time intervals. So purchase price of a material fluctuate on account of three reasons. First one is change in the product price. Second one, buying from different supplier. So each and every supplier, they'll quote different price. So that is also one of the reason for price fluctuation. And third one is some supplier, they'll allow some quantity discount, trade discount or cash discount. So that is also one of the reason for price fluctuation. But here we need to ascertain the exact cost of material issue to the production department. It is the duty of the storekeeper to record all the information about the unit or raw material purchased from different supplier. Whenever they receive any item or any units or any number of units from the supplier, they'll make entry in a chronological order. And after that, they'll receive material requisition form from the production department. After receiving the material requisition form from the production department only, the storekeeper will issue the material to the required or production department. In such case, they need to value or they need to price of material issue. Whenever they issue material, they need to find the exact price for the unit. In such case, they need to follow any one method of pricing of material. In this video, I am going to explain only two methods which is very important. The first one is FIFO method. FIFO method means first in, first out method. So it's very simple concept. So whenever he receives any unit or from the supplier, immediately storekeeper need to record in his books of accounts, that is stores ledger. In stores ledger, whenever he receive goods or issue goods to production department, he need to record both the transaction so that every time whenever he receive any item, he need to see the balance. Then whenever he issue any units to production department, he need to find out how much after issuing the unit, how much unit balance are there. All these things should be properly maintained by the storekeeper. So let me explain the basic concept about FIFO. FIFO means FIFO, first in, first out. So according to this method, when an issue is made to the production department, the price of the earliest lot in the stock is charged to the receiving department. When the lot is exhausted, the next lot is used at the respective price of that particular lot. This method resembles the queue system. So according to FIFO method, as a storekeeper, we need to issue the lot from the earliest one. So which one is earliest? First in, first out. First we have received or purchased some unit from the particular supplier. No, we need to exhaust the first lot. And after exhaust, after completing the entire unit only, then we need to go for second lot. So it will be like queuing system. So according to this rule only, the storekeeper can able to issue and the storekeeper can able to price the material issue. This is called as pricing of material according to FIFO method. So let us see the problem. With the help of this problem, you will have a thorough knowledge about FIFO method. From the particulars given below, write up the store's ledger card. So they ask you to prepare store's ledger according to FIFO method. So first one, 2015 May, first opening stock 1200 units at the rate of 20 each. So last year closing stock will be the opening stock for current year. No, this is the opening stock. And then on 2nd May, they have purchased 600 units at a rate of 19 rupees 50 paise. Then on 5th May, issued 800 units. On 12th, purchased 1300 units at a rate of 19 rupees each. And on 15th, issued 1250 units. On 20th, purchased 1000 units at the rate of 20 rupees each. On 29th, issued 1700 units. On 30th, purchased 1000 units at the rate of 22 rupees each. On 31st, issued 750 units. So these are the transaction. With the help of this information, you have to prepare, adopt the FIFO and LIFO method of issue and ascertain the value of closing stock. I have already explained about the FIFO. Let us see the answer according to this method. After that, I'll explain about LIFO method. Now I'm going to prepare store's ledger account according to FIFO method, first in, first out method. This is a general standard format of store's ledger account. Name, code number, description, maximum level, minimum level, reorder level, reorder quantity, folio number, bin number, location code. And then you have to record the date of each and every transaction. Date column, in particular column, when the storekeeper receive any material from the supplier, he need to write the reference number, that is goods received note number. When he issue any item or any material to production department, he need to write the reference, that is material requisition number. These are the two important terms which is required to record the transactions related to material purchased and material issued. So date column, particular column is over. Then we need to have three separate columns. First column to record the receipt. When he purchase any item, when he receive any material from the supplier, he need to record now how many number of quantity received and each quantity price and amount. For example, 100 units, each unit price 2 rupees. Then 100 into 2, 200 rupees. In the same way, whenever he issue any material to production department, he need to record how many number of unit issued and each unit price. This is a very important. You need to decide on what basis you are going to fix the price for the production department. So according to FIFO or LIFO, so based on that you have to decide the rate per unit and amount, and finally you will have balancing figure. So after issuing some material to production department, you need to see how many number of units in hand, that is you need to find out the balancing figure. After finishing each and every entry, you need to find out the balance, then only you can go for next step. So first one, 2015 May 1st, opening stock 1200 units at 20 rupees each. So enter this item under particular column and you have to show this amount in balance column, because this is the opening stock. No, last year closing stock is the opening stock for the current year. 2015 May 1st, opening stock. No, just write balance brought down. Balance brought down. How many number of units? 1200 unit. Each unit price 20 rupees. No, just multiply 1200 into 20. Yes, 24,000. Second one, on 2nd May 2015, purchased 600 units. Each unit cost 19 rupees 50 paise. Just enter this item in receipt column, because he purchased 600 units. I told you, no, you have to mention, you have to write the reference. When you receive any purchase, when you receive any raw material from the supplier, you need to write goods received note number. That is GRN number, goods received note number. You have to write the reference number for the purchase transaction. So when you purchase item, that will be entered in the receipt column. How many number of units? 600 units, no? 600 units. Each unit cost 19 rupees 50 paise. Just multiply 600 into 19.5. 11,700. Already you had 1200 opening balance. Now 600 units added, no? Just you have to balance this. So already 1200, 20 rupees each, 24,000 balancing figure. Now we have made additional purchase, 19 rupees 50 paise, 11,700. Just draw a line. Next, on 5th May, issued 800 units. Already we had opening balance of 1200 units and we have made a purchase for 600 units. Total 1800 units are there. Now we need to issue 800 units to production department. So we need to find from which lot we are going to issue. So according to FIFO method, first we need to issue the earliest one. We have to exhaust the first one. After exhausting the entire thing, then we can take the next lot. That is according to queue system we have to issue. So now we have two lots, no? One is opening stock and next purchase 600. So total 1800, no? We have to decide from which lot we are going to issue. So according to FIFO method, we have to concentrate first one. First in, we need to exhaust the first one. After exhausting the entire thing only, we can able to see the next one. So now we have 1020 sufficient units are there, no? Just take 800 rupees from opening stock and consider the 20 rupees for issue price and show the amount in issue column. On 5th May, 800 units issued, no? You have to write the reference. For purchase, you have to write goods received note number. When we issue any item to production department, we have to write material requisition number. Material requisition number. Okay, this is a reference for the particular transaction. How many number of units is required by the production department? 800 units, no? Just look at the balancing figure. Opening balance 1200 units are there. And next purchased on 2nd, 600 units are there. So according to FIFO method, we have to take only from the earliest one. Earliest one is 1200, no? From 1200, we can issue 800 units. 800 units. Which price? Two prices are there, no? First one is 20 price, 20 rupees. Second one 19 rupees 50 paise. So we, according to FIFO method, we have to take the first one, earliest one. So 20 rupees is there, no? 1000 out of 1200, each price 20 rupees. We are going to issue 800 units at the rate of 20 rupees each. 20 rupees. Just multiply 16,000. So after finishing the transaction, you need to find out the balancing figure. Out of 1200, you have issued 800. What is the balance? 400 balance is there. Each price 20. Then 600 also is there. We didn't issue the 600. 600 into 15, 19, 50. Just multiply this value. Enter in amount column. 8,000. 600 into 19 is 11,700. Next transaction, on 12th May 2015, purchased 1300 units at a rate of 19 rupees each. So enter this item under receipt column. So when you enter purchase transaction, you have to write goods received note number. On 12th, you have purchased, no? So goods received note number. You have to write the reference for the purchase. How many number of unit purchased? 1300 units, no? Just enter receipt column. 1300 units. Each unit price 19 rupees each. Just multiply 1300 into 19 rupees. 24,700. Immediately, you have to record the balance also. So already we had 400 into 20 rupees each, 8,000. And second one, 600 also is there. 19 rupees 50, 11,700. Now we have made additional purchase, no, 1,300. Add along with the previous balance. 1,300, 19 rupees. What is the value? 24,700. In the same way, for each and every transaction after entering the receipt or issue, immediately we need to see the total balance. Next one, on 15th May, issued 1250 units. In order to record the issue transaction, you have to record material requisition number as reference. On 15th, you have issued, no, so you have to write material requisition number to show which department asked. So the information is regarding the requisition of material. How many number of units issued? 1250. So before you enter 1250 units here, you need to find out from which lot you are going to issue, because we have 400 as separate lot, 600 at 1950 and 1319. So according to FIFO method, we have to exhaust the first one. We need to issue from the first balance. This is called as FIFO method. First in, first out. We have 400. Then second option goes to 600 lot. Third option will go to 1300 lot. So first we need to exhaust the first one. 400 units is there, no? Just take the 400 units and issue this item. Record this in issue column. 400 each unit price, 20 rupees, no? 8,000. How many number of units required? 1250. We have issued only 400. Remaining is there, no? Next lot. Just look at the next lot. We have 600, no? So again, you can take the this one. 600 at the rate of 19 rupees 50 pies. 11,700. So how many number of units required by the production department? 1250. So far we have taken 1000. 400 from the first one, 600 from the second one. Total 1000 is over. Remaining 250 is there, no? So that 250 you can take from the third one. 250 each price 19 rupees, no? Just multiply 250 into 19. 4750. Now find out the balance. You have issued 400, 600 also fully exhausted. From 1300 you have issued 250. Now we have balance only 1050 units. Each price 19. What is the amount? 19,950. Next one, on 20th, purchased 1000 units at 20 each. So you have to record this information. What is the reference number? Goods receipt note number. On 20th, you have purchased, no? So you have to write the reference. Goods receipt note number as reference number. So how many number of units purchased? 1000, no? Enter receipt column. 1000 units, each unit price 20 rupees. Just multiply with this 20,000. Now we have to show the balancing figure. So already we had 1050 each 19 rupees, 19,950. Now we have purchased 1000 units, no? At the rate of 20 rupees, 20,000. Next, on 29th May, issued 1700 units. Now we have to issue 1700 units from the balance. And 29th, you are going to issue 1700 units to production department. No, you have to write the reference number. Material requisition number you have received, no? You have received material requisition note from the production department. You have to write the reference for the transaction. So how many number of units you require by the production department? 1700 units. See the first one. So according to FIFO method, first you have to issue the first one, 1050. Take this balance and issue 1050 each price 19 rupees, 19,950. Still we need to issue 650, so that you can take from the second lot. 1000 units are there, no? From 1000 units you can take 650. You have to charge this price, because you have taken from this lot, no? You have to charge this price, 20 rupees. So 650 into 20, 13,000. Okay, so what is the balance? 1050 fully exhausted, fully issued to production department. From 1000 units, you have taken 650. So remaining 350 units are there. Each unit price 20 rupees. No, just multiply and find the amount. 7000. Next transaction, 30th May 2015, purchased 1000 units at 22 rupees each. Enter this transaction under receipt column. On 30th, purchased 1000 unit. No, so you have to write goods receipt note number. How many number of unit purchase? 1000 units. Each unit price 22 rupees. So 22,000. Just enter the balance column. Just fill the balance column. Already 350 is there. 20 rupees each. 7000 amount. And now we have purchased 1000 unit. No, each price 22. Total 22,000 rupees. Then last one. On 31st May, issued 750 units to production department. 31st issued. No, you have to write material requisition number. So how many number of units? 750 units. So according to FIFO method, you have to take from the first one, earliest one. 350 is there. Now first issue this one. 350. 20 rupees each. 7000 is over. So 750 is required. 350 is given. Still we need 400 units, no? So that we can take from the next lot. 1000 units are there, no? From 1000 you can take 400 units. 22 rupees. What is the amount? 8800. So what is the balance? 350 is given. From 1000 we have issued 400 units. Remaining we have only 600 units at the rate of 22 rupees. So you need to find out the amount. 13,200. After entering all these transactions, storekeeper need to write the closing stock. How many number of units are there in balancing column? 600 units. Each unit price 22 rupees. Amount 13,200. No, that you need to write here. Closing stock 600 units at 22 rupees each. Amount rupees 13,200. Let me explain once again. First you need to show the balancing figure, opening balance 1200 into 20 rupees, and then on second purchase made 600 units purchase. No, that you need to record under receipt column. 600 purchased at a rate of 19 rupees 50, amount 11,700. So you need to balance each, and after finishing each and every transaction you need to show the balancing figure. So already 1200 into 20, and now we have purchased 600. No, total 1800 is there, and out of that on 5th they are issued 800 units to production department. So you have to write like this, material requisition note number. 800 units, no, you have to take from the first one. So first one we have 1200. From 1200, 800 units issued. What is the balancing figure? From 1200 units you have issued 800, balancing figure 400, and second lot 600 is there. Total 1000 lot is there as balancing figure. Next, on 12th purchase made for 1300. Again you have to balance the item. First one 400 balancing figure is there, and 600. Now we have purchased 1300. So total 2300 is there. Out of that, on 15th 1250 units required by the production department. You cannot take from the 1300. You have to go according to the order. FIFO method, no? First you need to take from the first one. 400 is there. You can take the 400 and you can issue the 600 also. Total 1000 is over. Still we need 250. That 250 you can take from the last one. Balancing figure 1050 at the rate of 19 rupees. 19,950. On 20th the goods purchased for how many units? 1000 units purchased at the rate of 20 rupees each. 20,000. You have to balance that. See, already 1050 is there. Additional purchase made 1000. Total 2050 is there. And then on 29th 1700 units required by the production department. So first you need to take first lot, from the first lot 1050. Remaining 650 is required, no? That you can issue from the balancing figures. 1000 is there, no? From 1000 you can take 650. Balance 1000 minus 650, 350. Then on 30th, you have purchased 1000 unit. So already we have 350 and again purchased made now 1000 add. Total 1350 units are there. From that on 31st May, again 750 units required by the production department. So from 1350 you have to take the first one 350. Balance 400 units required. No, you can take from the 1000. So balance 1000 minus 400, 600 units. So closing stock as on 31st May, 600 units at the rate of 22 rupees. Total 13,200. According to FIFO method, you have to find out closing stock. Now I'm going to explain LIFO method. LIFO means last in, first out method. So I'm going to explain LIFO method with the help of same problem. See, according to LIFO method, the price of material last purchased and kept in stores is charged for the issue first, and then the preceding lots purchased are issued. This is a simple procedure for LIFO method. According to FIFO, we have to take the first method, earliest purchase will be issued, and then we have to proceed according to queuing system. But according to LIFO method, we have to issue material from the last purchase. So that is a difference between FIFO and LIFO. Let us see the problem. First one, opening stock 1200 units at 20 rupees each. 2015 May 1st, balance brought down. How many number of units are there? 1200. No, just enter under balance column. 1200 quantity or unit. Each unit 20 rupees. No, what is the amount? 24,000. On second purchase, 600 units at 19 rupees 50 paise each. On 2nd May, purchase. For the purchase transaction, you have to record goods received note number. How many number of units purchase? 600 unit note that you have to write under receipt column. 600 units at 19 rupees 50 paise each. 11,700. Just write the balance. Already 1200 units are there as opening balance, 20 rupees each, 24,000. Now we have purchased 600 units at 19 rupees 50 paise each, 11,700. Then on 5th, issued 800 units. No, for issue you have to write material requisition number. 5th, issued to production department. No, so material requisition number. How many units required by the production department? 800. According to LIFO method, you have to issue from the last lot. Already we have 1200 as opening balance and we have purchased 600 units. No, from these two lots, we have to take the from the last one. So last 600 is there. No, from that you have to issue. So 800 units is required. No, enter 600, you can issue. 19 rupees 50 paise. 11,700. So out of 800, 600 issued, remaining 200 is there. No, that 200 you can take from the next one, next option. After exhausting the entire thing, the next option is 1200 is there. No, from 1200 you can issue 200 units. Total 800 is over. No, 4000. Okay, so now 600 is issued. Now we have 1200. From 1200 you have issued 200. Balance 1000 units are there at 20 rupees each, 20,000. On 12th, purchase 1300 units at a rate of 19 rupees each. So purchased, you have to enter the transaction under receipt column. On 12th, goods receipt note number. How many number of units purchased? 1300. No, just write under receipt column. 1300 into 19 rupees each, multiply with this, 24,700. Just find out the balancing figure. Already we had 1000 units at 20 rupees each, 20,000. Now we have made additional purchase. No, 1300 units at 19 rupees each, 24,700. Next, on May 15th, issued 1250 units. So you have to record this information under issue column. on 15th, you have to write material requisition number for issue. So how many number of units required by the production department? 1250. So according to LIFO method, you have to issue from the last one, last in first out, 1250 at the rate of 19 rupees each, 23,750. What is the balance? 1000 is there, we didn't issue 1000. 1020 rupees each, 20,000 is there. From 1300 we have issued 1250. What is the balance? 50 units, each unit 19 rupees. So what is the amount? 950. On 20th, purchased 1000 units at a rate of 20 rupees each. So you have to record in receipt column because you have purchased, acquired the raw material, no? So on 20th, goods received note number. How many units? 1000 units. So enter receipt column. 1000 units at the rate of 20 rupees. 20,000. Again, you have to balance. First lot 1000 rupees, 1000 units into 20 each, 20,000 is there, and 50 units at the rate of 19 rupees each, 950 is there, and now we have purchased 1000 units, no? 1020 rupees each. Total how many units are there? 2050 units. Next, 29th May issued 1700 units. On 29th, you need to issue 1700, no? For issue, you have to write material requisition number. How many units required by the production department? 1700, no? According to LIFO method, you have to take from the last one. So 1000 lot is there, no? 1000 unit is there in the last lot. Just take from the last one, 1000. Just issue the entire thing because you need to issue 1700, no? 1000 into 20 rupees each. 20,000 rupees, and still we need to issue 700. You have to go for the next one. Next option is 50. You have to issue the entire 50. 950. So how many number of units required by the production department? 1750. So far we have issued 1050. No, still we need 650 that we can take from the last one. From 1000, 650 you have to take. 20 rupees, 13,000. You have to write the balance. Entire 1000 lot is issued, 50 also issued. Now we have only 1000. From 1000 you have issued 650. So balancing figure is 350 units at 20 rupees each, 7000 rupees. Next, on 30th May purchased 1000 units at 22 rupees each. So you have to enter this transaction under receipt column. On 30th, goods received note number. How many number of units purchased? 1000 units at the rate of 22 rupees each, 22,000 balance. Last balance 350 into 20 rupees each, 7000. Now we have purchased 1000 additional purchase, 22 rupees each, 22,000. The last one, on 31st May issued 750 units. So you have to record this information under issue column, 31st. So you have to write material requisition number for issue. So how many number of units required by the production department? 750 units, no? According to LIFO method, you have to take from the last lot. That is recent. The last one is 1000 unit, no? From 1000, you have to issue 750. 750 at the rate of last one, 22 rupees each. 16,500. Balance 350 is there. We didn't issue 350 units. 20 rupees each, 7000, and from 1000 you have issued 750 according to LIFO method. What is the balancing figure? 1000 minus 750, 250 into 22 rupees, 5500. Now you need to write the closing stock. Okay, closing stock is equal to how many units? 350 units and 250 units. Total 600 units. Okay, valued at, just take the total, 7000 plus 5500. 350 into 20 plus 250 into 22. What is the total? 12,500. This is a value. 600 units in value, 12,500. So according to LIFO method, this is the closing stock. Now we can compare with the FIFO method. See, according to FIFO method, closing stock is 600 units at 22 rupees each, value 13,200. According to LIFO method, closing stock is 600 units but valued at 12,500. That is the difference between FIFO and LIFO. FIFO means first in, first out. You have to issue from the first lot, earlier lot. According to LIFO, you have to issue from the last lot. It's called LIFO method. Last in, first out. Hope you could understand the FIFO and LIFO method from this video. Thank you.